So we're at DTW Ignite 2025. We're in Copenhagen. I'm here with Jean-Christophe Laneri from Ericsson. Jean-Christophe, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So what kind of business challenges are driving the need for autonomous networks? And how does your collaboration with AWS address this?
So the way we see it is that the customers are really two big challenges, I would say, in the industry right now. Some are driven by the need of business agility, right? Being able to launch new services much faster, you know, going from months to a few minutes or seconds. Some others need to streamline operations, right? Meaning, how can they continuously optimize the network, reprogram the network without any human intervention, right? Like, these are really the key drivers for us. And we're working really hard to make sure that we can solve this problem and, of course, leveraging AWS capabilities, you know, to do just that.
Okay. And can you explain how Ericsson's cognitive network solutions portfolio leverages AWS's AI capabilities?
So, yeah, I mean, we're very excited about the collaboration that we kicked off now around agentic AI. Maybe before I talk about agentic and reasoning, I think we need to take a step back on what is it we're doing, right? We're really solving use cases that allow us to, you know, step by step take humans out of the loop in terms of network operation and network optimization. Mm-hmm. Now, when you start having all these applications that can run in parallel, you know, the typical way of working would be to have a human in the loop to look at the different trade-off, right? Because networks are typically about trade-offs, you know, capacity and coverage, different trade-offs in the network. So to be able to, you know, take the human out of the equation here, we need to introduce reasoning, right? And this is where I think the collaboration with AWS comes into the picture, with agentic AI, to see how can we resolve this reasoning layer, to be able to resolve the trade-off based on, you know, what kind of SLA business objectives the CSPs have.
Okay. And what kind of specific benefits can CSPs expect from this collaboration in terms of distinct operational improvements?
So very clearly, first number one is being able to launch new services much faster, right? Like, second one is of course to have superior network performance, improved network performance at a lower operational cost, right? Like, these are to us the two big drivers why we're doing this in the first place.
Okay. And looking ahead, how do you see this collaboration shaping the way that that telecom services and telecom networks evolve?
I mean, we're definitely shaping, I think, the industry now, because, you know, for these systems to be able to introduce reasoning and introduce full autonomy, we also need to, you know, if the machine is supposed to be autonomous, then we need to be able to steer the machine, right? And for example, here at DTW, we're introducing a catalyst where we're showing how end-to-end intent would work across the stack, the telecom stack, right? Like where we would be, you know, be able to give on a high layer a business objective, and that would trickle down all the way to how the network is configured and reprogram all the time. So this is definitely something that is, to me, a world first, and that we're going to keep pushing now in the industry.
Okay. Well, so, I mean, there's obviously a lot going on behind the scenes here, a lot underpinning all of this. Where can people find out more about this collaboration so they can learn what is really driving all of this?
Well, I really advise everyone to check the cognitive technology, you know, webpage we have on Ericsson.com. That would be a great starting point.
Okay. Excellent. Jean-Christophe, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you.